Alright, let's continue Rogue Legacy. If you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for clicking. Hope you've been enjoying so far. So, I mean, I'm kind of at the end of this. I'd imagine there's going to be a little bit more grinding. But otherwise, it's learning this fight, whatever it might be. This ability. And we'll see. This weapon I've used once before and it just... I don't know. It's cool, but it just seems like it's gonna cause problems. I guess we'll see. So I'll do some running around first, see what we can get out of this. It's probably too dangerous. Until one food is eaten. Let's try it. Ooh. Bad room. Here lies the problem with this item. Fine control. Oh, cool. Alright, we're safe now. Still take damage. Sure, why not? Ah, oh, crap. This is gonna go poorly. I can't control the dash on this weapon. Oh boy. Alright, I picked this character because it had a gold bonus. That's pretty much it. I guess let's find out what this is. Beware the allure of gold, it's heavier than it looks. Raven's Ring. Some run from death. Alright, let's just find out what it is. Oh, it's like weapon damage. Interesting. still think most of the special weapons in this game are just too annoying. They're cool, but it's just... In a boss scenario, not being able to control your movement properly. But I'll explore the map, I'll get money, and then we'll see what we can do. I'm not convinced this is gonna be able to do the last fight. If it were to let me not take damage as I dash through enemies, provided I hit them, that'd be cool. That would make this weapon so much better. But I can't stop short, it's just, it travels a fixed distance every time. Or even just destroying projectiles, just any sort of benefit to dashing through stuff. I'll see what I can do. I want to get a couple of items, so then at least I'm using the resolve. To gain a 20% bonus. Glowing Ember. What is this? Deals 75% more damage on every 6 hit. Well, that's useless. I have to hit 6 times with this scythe and it does a lot of damage. It's fitting. I guess if I can pull it off, that's a lot of damage. Okay, I see, I see. It's okay. Oh, right. I just realized something else. This character's move is like a combo as well. Your weapon deals 50% more damage, but has a cooldown. Interesting. That kind of works with this anyway. Like, I wouldn't want to be spamming it. Alright, this is kind of legit. Oh wait, there's more up there. I'll stick to what I have. This combination seems interesting. If I manage to hit 6 times with this, it does a lot of damage. Destroy all targets. Oh, okay. I've never seen that one before. I'm gonna laugh if this ends up as a successful run. Like, here I am thinking that this won't work, but it might. I guess I can just teleport to blue now. I'll clear up the snow at the very least, and then maybe have an attempt at the boss. Damage is no joke. It's one-shotting most things. This thing. I have no idea how to do this. Yeah, screw this one. That involves some very specific knowledge. And lots of fun. Just question how this is gonna go ultimately. That one's tricky. Jeez, that was annoying. Maybe. We'll see. Not enough to one shot yet. I mean, if nothing else, it'll make a cool thumbnail having this weapon. So, I mean, that's the problem with this thing. Ow, wow, wow. Interesting. Is this like... Am I being stupid here or what? I guess we'll see. Every point below resolve increases damage. This is like major glass cannon. Hmm. I mean, I'm gonna try and get my health to 400. That's a good target, I think. Defeat all enemies, huh? Health increase, hopefully. Okay. I see no issues in what I'm doing. I'm good. Hey, just... I really hope this does become something that works out. Like, this effectively is a Reaper build. So much damage. But then there's so much things relating to death. Hey Gammy, how's it going? Got it. I wasn't gonna do much. I mean, even the kick is doing significant damage here. Oh my god. How am I doing? Alright, just kicking back. Oh no. I don't really have to heal everything. I'm gonna restore a large amount of health anyway. No, thank you. Oh shit. Did I get a good upgrade? I wouldn't call this an upgrade. I would call this just the most double-edged swords of double-edged swords. I'm not gonna win, but I mean, I'll get some money out of it at least. I have this weapon that does a slash attack, but I have no control over when to stop it. So you have to time it right. And then I have a bunch of shit that like rewards me for having low health, so it's just this thing that just is ripping through enemies, but it's risky. That is so annoying. I might die here. No, got it. Ooh, shit. Probably not worth the effort. What is it? I mean... Can't grab that. I think that's everything. No, there's one more room. Oh, neat. Ooh, that's bad. I might die. Okay, never mind. My passive went off so I don't die. I have a 50-50 chance of not dying when a fatal blow is gonna get dealt to me. Alright, well... this is probably as good as it's gonna get. Alright, I guess try. This is just, I guess, a battle of knowledge. I just need to know more about his attacks. Oh, he has that weapon too. No, he has everything. Well, the 50-50 didn't work. Alright, it doesn't matter. I'm more interested in the money. Well, I guess if I'm gonna pick one, it's gonna be Chef. Alright, I went with armor. And go health. I think I need to journey more in the caverns to get higher tier armor. Alright, well this'll... I guess I'll do the same as last time. I'm not sure which class will be good at fighting that thing. I think it's gonna take a few attempts. I'm not sure how to avoid that slash attack it does. Oh, whatever. At this point, I'm after more just items as opposed to money. Just put that resolve to use. Good. One down, two down. That's way too defensive. No, neither. I want something that gives me attack. I'll take the health increase. I should get the power to let me reroll. I'm gonna invest in that next. Annoying. This one, it's a good one. I definitely gotta take some risks and go into the caverns area. There's also the, like, I wouldn't call it boss rush, but I guess enemy rush, whatever you call it. I need to do some of those, because they do make passives more effective. Just any extra bit of advantage I can get. Yes. Oh, wait. It's a talent. No. I'll keep it in mind. Maybe for the boss fight. But not whilst I'm exploring. Tethered rope. Let's go. That one's pretty fun. Alright. Over that way. It's quicker to go down. Okay. Just hoping I get some decent items. Oh wow, that that was a lot of food at once. Hopefully ones that apply more damage over time. I've got two damage over time skills. Magic would also be very useful, like taking, getting extra mana on hit. Sure. Ugh, that poison damage. Oops. I gotta remember to eat when I see one of those. Consume. No. No. Oh, this is bad. I have no idea how to get in there. gotta be a fake spot down here somewhere. I don't know what's up with that room. Zoom. Oh no, this is like, if I want to do a spell spam build, this is the one. As curious as I am about the other one, like being able to throw poison constantly. This is the way. Again! Gold. I can be immune to spikes. Let's see what this is. Huh. Interesting. Wonder if that stacks with kick. Alright, keep going. Seems legit. This is a lot of fun. Another Rage Tonic. I'll stack that. Oh, damn. That was scary. Soup. See ya. Thank you. I'm quite the stompy boy. I can see how this is going to be useful in proximity. No idea. Damn, that was a kick. Oh, nice. And that was worthwhile. Even if I don't get that. just by jumping. I can kill. It's pretty great. Jeez, that AoE is no joke. That was really quick. I definitely feel inclined to visit more. Okay. Let's go to the study! Because why not? Just by landing. Even if I don't win this run has been fun. This ability is awesome. Just shows the power that this thing has, like, with rage as well. Nice. Give me the hell. All the hell. With this thing. I mean, it would be funny to get a second one, but I think I'm fine. It's not a damage dealer. It's a cool utility item. Like, at this point, I'm doing all this to tank up. Above all else. Getting pretty lucky with this food. These boots are the best. Like, I'm jumping purely for the sake of jumping now. Thank you. Health, please. Thank you. At this point, I don't think anything is going to be worth taking the health hit. Like, I'm just going to tank up and hope for the best. This thing has a bigger range than I thought it would. When I read the description, I was like, okay, Quake, that's probably not gonna do a lot. Okay, there's a few more passageways. Okay. Just got that thing by quaking. Ether. Eh. It's fine. I think I got plenty. I'm guessing this is after what I'm doing, anyway. Fine. Oh, nice. Thank you. This is what I want. Just stack health. Alright, I think we're done here. I'm gonna keep going. Usually I avoid the sun tower, but I think what I have going is fine. Oh boy. I'm just gonna explore every area, I think. At this point, I may as well. Just get the most out of money and unlocks. What's this? Oh yeah, this is the lore room. It's fine. This one. I like this one. Okay. Increases your crit damage. Damn, that's a useful one. Fine. enrage thing is super useful as well. Thank you. I can't think of a practical use for that one. Standing still. When am I gonna stand still? Oh, crap. What is this? Ugh, that was annoying. I'm good. Admittedly, it's getting a little scary. No, thank you. I can get him through the wall. Ah! Go, Boots, go! Jeez, I think I don't want to die quickly. I mean, getting there. Nice, nice. Okay, I'll go out that way later. Weapon Applies combo would be useful, but 41 resolve. I don't want to dip my health. I think I've got a good thing going here. Okay. I don't think I've ever done this before. I don't think I've ever been down here just for the sake of exploring. So this is new. I'm hoping to leave with the new armor piece or something. Nice room. The blades on the air. Shit! I didn't get it in time. You just got the game and you have a question. Why don't I take Relic? Because it'll reduce my health if I do. And I don't want to reduce my health. Pretty much the number in the top right, where you see it's 104%. The moment it starts dropping below 100%, it takes a percentage of your health every time. So if I was to take it, it's not that the relic is bad, it's that it's going to cost me health. A lot of health. Which is why you increase your resolve. I want to be, tanky. Yeah. So it's a bit of a trade-off, like, you can choose to sacrifice your health. But for me, I'm gonna fight a boss that I'm gonna need all the health I can get. That made it worth it. I think that's an upgrade. I'll drink soup for now. Ice trail. Ooh, bad room, bad room. It's alright, I got food. Nice. Not sure if that's going to be better, but at least it's a weapon. This is why I came here. Boots are so good. Okay. I'll be fine. Yes. Need to find the warp point out of here. Lucky. It's either to the right or to the left. I'll go right. Health, so I think I can explore the rest of the map. I'm probably gonna lose to the boss, so I want to make this run worth it. Be good, but I don't want to reduce my health. That one's not bad. Consume. Thank you. I just want to trust that having health is going to get me through this. Apparently there's lore here. Guess I may as well. If you've never played a roguelike before, pretty much every time you play the game, the rooms and enemies are random. I mean, each room within an area will have a theme, but you won't have the same layout twice, generally speaking. That's the appeal of these games, is every time you die and play again, it's different. So you don't experience the same thing twice. Yep, I'm gonna do this. Damage. Okay. That would have been good to get early, but I feel like at this point it's probably going to be more dangerous than good. Is worth taking the hit on. Oh wow, okay. Guess I'm fine again. Okay. That one has to be an upgrade. If nothing else, I at least have a weapon. Don't need to do that. Sure. Ah, damn it. It's one with traps. Wasn't too bad. Could have been worse. Yeah, but like, I want to keep my health. Reset. Did it die? Yes. I can't believe I'm gonna explore this whole area. Yeah, but like, again, health. You'd die in 2 seconds, what's all that? You slowly build up your character, like, every time you do a run, you just spend your money and it becomes stronger. How many hours have I spent? Wouldn't be able to tell ya. Hang on, I have to check Steam. Because I stopped playing this game for a few months when Zelda came out. Apparently 24 hours, so there you go. Not as much as you would think. Ooh. Free eats. Thank you. Not so much. Yeah, not really. I mean, I play a lot of these kind of games, like roguelikes, but also kind of grew up on stuff like Castlevania, so. Wait, which way is quicker? Then up and to the right. Gonna be very happy with this money. It's gonna buy me upgrades. Ah, it's a puzzle one, but I have to be quick about it. Yeah, no. Unless you know it right away, you're not gonna get it. That was a little scary. Wait, what's up here? Nothing? apparently another shielding one. It's just leather. Alright, but it's something. Is that it? No, there's one room. The very start, it would appear. Oh, scratch that. There's a couple rooms. Better be worth it. Alright, that's it. I have completed the whole map. Right? Yeah. No, I mean, I've actually done the whole map. For the first few runs, you need to go up, down, or through the map. The advice I can give you is, so see how every section of the map has a color? Stick to one color at a time. Every color has a major ability that'll let you get to the next color. So if you haven't found a major ability, then you can't continue. I mean, you can try. Some areas you can get to, but the enemies are going to be difficult, and you'll probably die very quickly. Like, I'm towards the end of the game here, so that's why I can go anywhere. Well, all this build up. Here we go. I didn't walk to the right. Is there anything to the right? A broken vial made from white wood sits at the shore. The contents are washed clean. Alright, nothing. Just lore. Okay, well, let's see how we go. I'm gonna check this side of the map. Oh, it's Karen. The toll belongs to another traveler. Speak to the one named Jonah to earn his blessings. Right. Alright. Ugh. All Holy crap. Just keep going. Melee. Jeez. I don't know how I'm supposed to dodge some of these attacks. Heal. Fire win! I got him. I was right about you, Traveler. You are not like the kink. Thank you for sparing me. I've seen your thoughts. I know now your intentions. The fruit is yours to do as you will. Speak to Karen to the west. Your journey home has been paid for in advance. Fruit of life. Traitor defeated. Alright. Wait, what? My journey ends here, Traveler. I made my choices long ago. It's time for me to accept the consequences. Alright, consume soup. Traveler, your passage has been paid for in advance. Your destination already determined. Interesting. No one's here. Oh. Oh shit. These are all my characters. Is this really going to be every single one? Oh, this is embarrassing. I mean, how many of them are they gonna be? No, that can't be all of them. There's no way. There should be way more than this. Okay. Whoa. Brother, you have returned bearing gifts. You have done what my children could not and brought the fruit of life. Too far have I divided myself, but with this I shall become whole once more. Okay, the timing on this is hilarious, but the controller just went flat. I plugged it in. Hold up. There we go. My children failed to tend to the garden and in turn failed me. You have brought an end to their dissidence and will be rewarded. In honor of your duties, brother, you shall rule the kingdom of Genesis. In this stead, continue to tend to the garden, brother, and someday you too shall rule by my side. Brother! Betrayer! Oh, okay. This music. Oh shit. Okay. Heal. Jesus, music. Well, either there's a second form. Brother, I will not go quietly. My body returns to Stygian, but the waters shall rise and my vengeance shall be sevenfold. That's just... Okay. Traveler, there's not much time. The water levels are rising, and if we don't do something quick, we're all going under. I'm down the hole in the supply closet. Come quick. Hey, Traveler. Since you slew the king, things have been going crazy. Castle Hamstons has started shifting, and the Stygian Ocean is rising, and rising fast. The land is going under, but I've got a plan. I can tell where the rooms will shift. I can feel there's something weird in the bowels of this castle, Traveler. Something powerful. This castle was brought down to this land, so I think it can go back up. There must be a mechanism that can get the whole thing to safety. And if my gut feeling is right, then this closet is going to be connecting to a room that leads to that very mechanism soon. This is our only chance. Get whatever it is down there working. I'll get all the refugees into. And here we're here. You're on your own from now. Good luck. Shit. Could have at least given me a heal. I'm not sure if that's significant. It's just background. Traveler, you are seen. I am Gilgamesh of the Miracle. The last wielder has perished. My soul returned to the sea. My power, free to bestow upon another. Traveler, earn your worth. Accept your challenge. You'll regain. Yes. Okay. Oh, time has slowed down. Stand behind, in front of, to raise the land. Oh. Okay. Interesting. Stones will return to their position if untouched. I mean, this is pretty fun. That was strange. Larger stones require more willpower to move the land. So it takes a while to wind it up. Honor, traveler. Your worth is proven. Your respect is due. Gilgamesh's anchor. Okay, well now we can do whatever this is. Oh, crap. Could keep going, apparently. What does this become? I probably should have seen what was on the left there and see if there was any heals, but you know what? It's fine. Oh no. We didn't save him? What on earth? You have returned. Child, you survived. You're lucky like me, aren't you? Also, are you also old like me? Psst, friend over there. I caught on a wave and it launched me all the way up here. Lucky, right? Wonder what I'll do now. Being in a bush ain't much better than being in a buoy. The change of scenery is nice though. Man, I'm glad someone came and carried me out. I'm not the fastest dummy, but I sink pretty good. Wait, what? Endings, am I right? I saw everything you did, traveler. It was amazing. What did they do? You probably have a lot of new souls you're looking to get rid of. And I just wanted to remind you that we're always on the market to buy. Ducky, you made it. Everyone was in a kerfuffle when the waters began to rise. I had to leave so quick. I left behind most of my pillows, but at least everyone's safe, and that's what matters. Still miss my pillows. Those last moments were wild, weren't they, kid? 1 minute I'm smithing, minding my own business, and the next minute folks are shouting that the water's rising. I just grabbed as much as I could and started climbing. I don't even know how much I lost. Don't know if I even care. You did it, traveler. You saved us all. Sorry, I couldn't help you. I had to go back and get as many people into Castle Hampson as possible. While you were fighting the estuaries, I was bringing refugees from the kingdom back across the Stygian Ocean with me. Thankfully, the folks in Castle Hampson were more than willing to take in villagers when the waters started rising. In the end, it was just people helping people, you know? Glad that's what it boiled down to. Parade? Okay, I don't know what I was expecting, but this is it. Jeez. I did the whole castle. I had to basically double my health to finish. I'm so glad I didn't take any other artifacts to lower my health. All that health was necessary. I would have died otherwise. They made it faster. Otherwise, we're gonna be here for ages. We. ...601 enemies. 64,000 gold. I lost to skeleton once. Oh, here we go. Lost to one. Lost three. I want to see what my most messed up enemy was. Three. So far, three's the worst. Okay, first boss I lost to 5-1, question mark. This is probably post-game. I reckon there's like a stronger form of the first boss post-game. Which these games tend to do. Apparently I never ran into the middle one. 1-1-1, that's fine. Pretty respectable so far. Most enemies is like a 3. Okay, 12 to the cannons, 102 to the sentry. Gee. Oh wait, no, it's defeated, not lost. Twice to those bosses. That's a harder version of the boss, I would imagine. Five times to that shield. That shield was annoying in the ice areas, I do remember that. I mean, I'm not seeing double digits for standard enemies, so that's something to be proud of so far. Five times. Really? I didn't die to a mimic once. That's surprising. Wow, okay. Twice to the middle one. Again, surprising. Huh. That one was the worst, 11 times. 6 to this one. 5 to that one. I think if it's 5 or less, I've done well. I do remember the one that I got 11 on. That was a struggle. Blink, blank, blonk. Some of these areas, these last ones, because I just haven't been in that area enough times. Only 3. And I thought that boss was going to take ages. It turns out it was one of the bosses I did really well against. The last one. Slug! Okay, yeah, I mean, this is more underground enemies. Look at that. First try. First try. First try. First try. I guess there's more stuff to discover, huh? Jeez, okay. Jonah. Only twice, surprisingly. First try! I actually did first try the final boss. Alright, well, I've reached the end of this. There's plenty more in terms of replay value here, like seeing all the enemy varieties, and I'm sure there are harder boss fights, but I think that's good enough for me. I enjoyed this game, and yeah. If I didn't have other stuff that I want to check out, I'd probably try to 100% it, but I think it's fine. It's definitely a big step up from the original. The original was a cool idea. I felt like it was a bit rough at times. But this one just polished the gameplay up so much in terms of fighting mechanics. Like, it felt pretty fluid. Though, yeah, I mean, if I was to give it one piece of critique, is just, I think the items lean more towards being double-edged swords than having things that are straight up beneficial. And maybe that's by design, but when you're used to playing stuff like the Binding of Isaac or any of the other roguelikes, it's, you certainly have those items, but they're not as widespread as they are in this game. But I guess it didn't stop me from finishing it, so there you go. Oh, cool, I can fast forward the credits. Anyway, this was Rogue Legacy 2. Sorry it was a bit scattered, as there was quite the gap between the playthrough. You can blame Zelda on that one. Well, let's just see what happens post-game. I want to see. I'll just go to the manor. Oh, so it's all set here now. The world is now complete, but your adventure is just beginning. New lore to discover, new bosses to defeat, new scars. The truth behind the world lies in another thread. I might look this up. If it's truly, like, just New Game Plus, or if there is, there is actually, like, a second ending to this. I'll look it up, but I think for the time being, that'll do it for this game. Pending me seeing if there's anything else to do. We'll see. Anyway, if you're watching later on YouTube, thanks for sticking around to the end. Hope you enjoyed me playing through this, and maybe we'll see more of this in the future, depending on if this is the end or not. I don't know. I'll look into it. But yeah, if you enjoyed yourself, be sure to click buttons if you want to support the channel for the algorithm stuff. Or maybe two other videos have popped up on your screen and you want to see me play something else. But till next time, bye YouTube.